Hey, it worked. Got it on the first try. Oh, wait, whoops. Yeah, good old-fashioned, I don't know. Just the pre-game ritual, I guess. Who do we find? Geth, goddammit. Luckily, I'm playing my infiltrator, so should be relatively okay. But anyway, what is up, ladies and gents? And welcome back to some more Mass Effect 3 multiplayer gameplay. I'm getting observed by hunters. That's what they do. And I am feeling a little dangerous today, so that's why we're going with the good old-fashioned platinums. Why not? It's been a while since I did a platinum game, and I have been using the shit out of this fucking harpoon. Oh, goddamn, the ragdoll effect on hunters. I love this. I like this gun. It's pretty good. But anyway, so why Kishuk again? Haven't you already done one of these? I don't know. I like this gun so fucking much. I just gotta use it again. And I don't think I did it complete justice during the Korean female infiltrator game because honestly, it can be better. So redoing it, doing a second look at the gun at our proper infiltrator, quote unquote proper. I don't know, if you really wanted to snipe and you wanted to be as effective as you possibly could, the Solarian Infiltrator is probably your best bet. Because, what the fuck, how did that miss? Uh-oh, bad accuracy. It burns! Oh, whoops. Didn't see that I reloaded. Yeah, this, maybe I should have put it to Cerberus for, dealing with less Geth bullshit. But if you had to ask me which infiltrator would be best, I would say the Solarian infiltrator, just all around. Hey, we got a fourth, how about that? All around a very solid class. It's very, and with energy drain, it makes them very survivable as well. Whereas, you know, with pretty much any other infiltrator, the issues of being squishy are present. Energy drain, cyclonic modulator, pretty damn powerful combination. Pretty hard to die. Pretty much have to go out of your way to die most of the time. What is going on up here? What killed you? A Geth turret. Okay then. Hey, what the fuck killed you? Missile launch? No, he's suppressor. We still got 9 rounds to go. What are you doing, maniac? Maybe platinum not the wisest of ideas for a Kishuk gameplay. I'd probably end up cutting myself off to noise suppressor. Why? Okay, hold on. Let me just get things under control here. Okay, things are not getting under control at all. God, the people are wasting their metagel too. So I've actually done a platinum run with the harpoon gun before, and I soloed round 8 and 9 by myself as teammates watch because that's kind of what you have to do when teammates die. So it's very platinum capable, very solid. Granted, you got good connection or your host. So just trying to demonstrate guns that ain't so popular. They are a little bit better than you may think. So Kishuk, I've already done it before, but in case you need to be reminded, very high powered, tons of fucking damage. Can get 2 shots with the cloak bonus because of the charge up mechanic. I'm only going to use 1 more rocket. Okay, maybe probably only should have used 1 there, but I don't know, maybe it wasn't a smart thing to use 2 rockets. Sometimes even on platinum you can get the mob to switch, so it's always worth what is with these people? And they're wasting of the metagels. Damn, overload teammates shaking my screen. Kishuk, high powered. High powered, does tons of fucking damage. Get 2 shots out of the cloak because of the charge up gun. It's actually a 300% headshot damage multiplier. So if you shoot anything in the head, it is going to die. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. And with the Solarian Infiltrator incarnation with this gun, you actually have something that is very anti-Phantom. So to say, if you once that's actually part of the reason why I wanted to do platinum, so that you can demonstrate, you know, the all-around versatility or usability of this gun. Excuse me. And still deal with Phantom at the same time. I didn't want to set it to Cerberus. It's a little too easy. Or at least I didn't want to do gold. How about that? I've already done gold. I haven't done platinum, so we're just doing that. I don't know. I'm not making a whole lot of sense right now. Maybe something to keep in mind for the future. Don't go into a platinum game. There's a lot to talk about. Probably not going to turn out too well. But anyway, Kishik, as far as bosses go, too, is actually fairly decent against Geth Prime and Banshees. Because they do have a much lower health pool than Atlas do. Atlas is kind of a slow war of attrition, so to say. Yeah, probably not going to hit something that far away. At least if it's moving. That's why we use Energy Drain for all stagger against the basic mobs. Oh, shit. Goddamn Geth Prime in there, laser action. Look at that one charged up shot. Took off 3 bars of shield, and that was without the proxy debuff, too. Well, not too shabby. Have to kill Geth Prime by herself. It is not going to take too long. Get the fuck out. Oh, no! Goddamn Geth Prime, shoot someone else. Send help. DY. Plus Guardians, innate piercing against Guardian shields, not too bad. I'm actually getting pretty handy with the kit. I've been using it a lot lately. Gotta vary up my weapon choices here on the account of I'm not trying to hold back on using shotguns and assault rifles. Definitely my go-to weapons of choice. Definitely my preferred weapons as well. God damn, what is with this guy? And you're lucky I got Scorpion for you, buddy. Jesus. People are wasting their metagel too fast. Still got a lot of platinum left to go. Gotta be careful. What's going on in here? Okay. So Solarian Infiltrator, as I was saying, tanky, energy drain, very survivable, plus proximity mine, always a good thing to have on your team, especially on platinum. You're going to need debuffs like those, especially if you find yourself pugging a lot. The more damage you and your teammates can do to the bosses and to the banshees, the faster that stuff is going to die, and you want that shit to die as fast as possible. It's very easy to get overwhelmed in platinum, especially when you've got banshees spawning in. And that's what I've noticed is in platinum. I play a little bit of platinum here and there. I do it every now and then. Just haven't been recording them because, well, I don't know. Lately, I've been running into some bad luck with platinum, though. Teammates make it hard, you know? Okay. Oh, yeah, we got Phantom spawning, too. I better try and demonstrate. See if I can get something to spawn out in the distance and show my super secret hidden phantom dealing with techniques. Yeah, that makes a whole lot of sense, I know, but just bear with me. Where's this phantom at? There she is. Look at that. Not too. And that was actually. Okay, so on gold, a fully charged up Kishik shot will kill a phantom regardless of where you hit her. And you can kind of cheese it because the bubble that they bring up actually counts as part of the Phantom's hitbox. Counts as part of the Phantom's hitbox. And you can actually end up shooting the bubble and doing a one-hit KO to the Phantom. And so for goal purposes, I mean, you shoot a proximity bomb, get that palm barrier absorption shit going on, and you're going to get a whole lot of Phantom kills over the course of the game. And the way you get it to bring it, get her to bring it up every time, is the way it works is they have to be a certain range away from you. They have to be a certain distance away, like let's say that for instance, a certain distance away in order for her to do it. Because if you're too close, what'll end up happening is is she'll just start doing the flippy stuff, and while that you can still line up a pretty good shot even through the flips, it's sometimes she'll react faster and not end up recover from her flip faster. It's weird. Preferably, you want to maintain a good distance away from phantoms. I mean, unless you've got the really kick-ass accuracy. So just line up the proximity, but in the way, oh yeah, it's and if you want her to bring up her bubble, you have to have the little orange targeting reticle around her, because if you like get a Ravager that's standing next to her, she won't bring it up, but if you have the orange little targeting thingamabobber, you know, that's how you do the trick. Maintain the distance and make sure you've got the little orange targeting marker thing. That's how you do that. I actually just figured this out recently too, with all of my Kishik uses, because I play a whole lot of I do play a lot of Glaciers. They're very close quarters maps, and so when I use proximity bomb, I was like, what the fuck? How come all these people that I see try that crazy technique? They always get the bubble up, but I don't. It's all about range. If you're too close, she'll do flips, and if you're far enough away, she'll do the little squat barrier pose thing, and that'll make it very easy for a Kishik headshot. So for gold, the bubble counts as part of the Phantom's hitbox, and that's really all you need to hit on gold. But for platinum, seems that you're gonna have to aim for the head at least. Or maybe not, that was just one guy. Sometimes it's a little wonky. Sometimes it'll one-shot him, sometimes it won't. Maybe I didn't get a full charge or something, who knows. This game, very buggy, as I've said before. This is actually going a lot smoother than I thought. This up-hack thing would be a lot easier if this idiot Turian was in here. I guess there's another good reason to do platinum. Showcase its usability against everything that this game has to offer. Make sure I like being in this position.
Get the fuck out of here.
I ain't been to that one, brother. I like the way that guy thinks. Get this stupid turret out of the way. Those are killers. And for Reapers, I mean, this thing just shreds. Brutes and Ravagers, no problem. Banshees probably take about maybe 6 shots, at least on gold. I don't know off the top of my head what it'll do to a platinum Banshee, but so one charged up shot, I think, regardless, difficulty is going to tank off at least 6 bars of barrier. And on gold, if you can land a proxy mine and charge up shot, that will interrupt a sink kill. And having that power at your disposal, always pretty good. And that should give you an idea of just how hard this thing is against both Geth and Banshees. Not too bad. And with proximity mine, she's bringing up Phantom Barriers. Cerber's pretty much a joke too. You know, with the problem with the Quarian female infiltrator is you can really only bring up that barrier if you have sticky grenades. But grenades, there's only a limited supply of those, but plenty of proximity mines to go around, so not too bad. How are we doing so far? Yeah! Domination of the scoreboard is what I like to see. We're not using too much of our consumables either, and that is always another good thing. Should be on pace. Fairly solid run. See, not too bad, even though I've got a destroyer with Piranha helping me out with that Banshee. This is still very very good source of damage against bosses, as long as it's not an Atlas. Atlas just takes too much to kill. And the thing about Atlas too is with these, the way the gun the Kishik works is it can't penetrate the canopy for a bug to hit on the Atlas, so that's why it may obviously falls behind compared to, you know, regular hit scan guns that can have armor piercing. Because the way that works, like someone actually, oh, shooting the canopy doesn't work against Atlas, you're wasting your time. And no, that guy, if you took his word for it, you are a fool. That is not the case. What the fuck is going on? Oh my god damn! easy to get overwhelmed with a sniper. Okay, guy going crazy. Okay, let's see what we can do about taking this bad girl out. Yeah, keep that mouth open wide. I got a nice harpoon for it. Yeah, we are definitely getting overrun. This is where problems in Platinum can happen if you don't got enough deeps to take down those Banshees quick enough, then very easy to get overrun. It's surrounded by a bunch of Pyros and Marauders. Bad things tend to happen. Kind of like this. And you just stand on stairways and trivialize Banshees. Fun times were had. What is going on here? Goddamn. Teleporting all over the place. Nope, nope. Why did she go for me? That's cheap. Probably shouldn't be missing Banshees with a sniper rifle. They're easy to hit. Can bring the A game. Yeah, I'm not going over there. Sorry. Now, why did he stop moving? Oh, I see you. Tricksy rascal. Need clips? No. And don't forget, as always, you can hip fire the harpoon gun. No hip fire damage penalty like the other sniper rifles would have seen. Another interesting thing, you can actually shoot while running, and that works with all charge gun, Geth plasma shotgun, Grawl, harpoon gun, acolyte. You can all shoot each of those on the move, so I don't know if you can make use of that, then go for it. I guess pyros don't die in one hit unless you get a perfect headshot on them. Probably the only ground level enemy that can survive a charged up shot from the Kishik. Everything else just fucking dies. What the? Okay, that was weird. Guy's mic bugging out as he's getting sync killed, or in the process of getting sync killed. Why are they hitting me? Yeah, throw Banshee balls at someone else. Also, for future reference, probably not going to be doing many Platinum videos. I wanted this to be a little more coherent, but I'm not really doing too much of a good job at it. What is, oh, his teammate shooting me in the back. Whoops. Yeah, this thing won't shoot through teammates either. Joys of charge-up weaponry. Take up Ravagers first. They are easy. Don't let Ravagers stay up for too long. Those are the things that'll just plant up or set up shop. Really pick your team apart. No one pays attention to it either. Practically goddamn snipers, and they three shot everyone. Pain in the ass. Make Ravagers a priority target if you see. Oh, I got you. See, look at that. Charged up. Charge up harpoon shot. And a proximity mine. Took that guy down pretty hard. Actually holding up a lot better than I thought we would. Oh, there's a Ravager. Oh, whoops. Nope. Gotta take care of Pyros. So that takes precedence first if they're bearing down on you. You don't want to help me kill these bad boys? Jesus. Okay, is this just the Banshee now? I think so, yep. Not too bad. That team's actually doing a lot better than I thought. We've recovered a bit from that first couple rounds of Metagel misuse. I know we got Phantoms to deal with. Oh, Geth Primes. I'd be happy if I never saw a Geth Prime ever again. I'm sick of that laser accuracy. Okay, that was a waste of a rocket. I don't know what these people are doing. See, there we go. Even with all the screen shaking, can still manage to headshot a Phantom. I do not like being in here. baby's first infiltrator sniper.
Oh, I do like ragdoll physics.
Ouch. Yeah, if you ever have troubles, if you want to learn how to snipe, hell, just take out the learning process and use a Solarian infiltrator. Stagger anything and everything, and you can stop phantoms in their place cold. God, no, keep run! Don't stop to reload, goddammit. I guess that was an headshot, and that still got her. I don't know, it's weird. Just gotta play around with it a little bit. Some places get one shot, others don't. You don't have to have ace sniping when you can shoot at something that's not moving, huh? If you lack the skill, just use a little technical know-how, I guess. Use a clever use of game mechanics. There we go, how about that? I should probably go revive him, that'd be smart.
I am the infiltrator after all.
Knock, knock, who's there?
Banshee! Banshee who? Banshee, I'm in your stomach, bitch!
That's how that conversation would go. Though I will say, regardless of how good or bad you are, definitely learn how to hit proximity mines on bosses that are, if you can't get a good proximity bomb.
To their feet! God damn it, that was cheating!
Always nice to help your team out with a little more boss deeps, 20%, nothing to scoff at.
See? Don't need to be a pro to make a shot like that. Just have to know that proximity bomb after a certain distance will proc that barrier for an easy 1-2 punch.
Oh, please tell me we gotta go to the LZ with that one.
And as always, in the little hack simulation thing. God damn it, I was gonna try and hit that. Oh, that'll work. Oh, shit, I don't wanna hop. Watch out, friend. Get out of there. Oh shit. Fuck it. Oh, Mark the Shark, don't do that.
Yeah, I'm not going back there for him. Ah, shit. We're gonna have to go all the way. Hey, this is where energy drain comes in handy.
Mark the Shark, for the love of God, just get in the blue!
Fucking Turian running through his life through a goddamn minefield right there. That's what that looked like.
Don't be afraid to use cover too if necessary during these things. I think a lot of people lose sight of that when doing these objects. Like, oh, I gotta stand near the thing and move all the time. No, you don't always have to do that. It does occasionally move through cover, and the radius is bigger than what it looks like, so feel free to use cover, or at least try to maintain the presence of mind to do that. That will save your life. Stop popping around, you crazy bitch. Oh, I think Mark the Shark just ran back out there. No, that was crazy fucking maniac. Yeah, that's kind of what you get. Proc the bubble. Easy headshot, see? Takes no skill to do that, just know-how.
Well, I guess know-how is a part of skill. Just depends on who you talk to, I guess.
Damn, I only went down once that round. That's actually pretty good for me. One second. I owe you. Down to the last enemy. Got one more. That's cheeky. Fuck, hit me out of stealth. Or while I'm in stealth, not cool.
Very good. That was actually fairly fast, too. Goddamn.
Only one of my one of the better platinum teams I've been on recently. Actually had a dry spell.
Come on.
Yeah, god damn, I didn't get over here fast enough. Now we gotta worry about shit spawning in here. That is not good. Definitely prepared to run around circles while teammates get swords and all manner of things in the implanted into their stomach or forcefully inserted. I think the team is starting to. I don't appreciate quitting, friend. Someone's got to keep this team together. No, run! Ah, fuck it. Everyone else wants to quit. Why not? No, we don't quit. Not in Sparta, we don't. I played Kratos too much. Spartans never give up, never surrender, never falter, never retreat, so on and so forth. Probably shouldn't stand in one spot for too long. Something to keep in mind when soloing. And you gotta watch out for Geth Prime too. They like to laser bullshit you. One thing that if you ever find yourself in a situation where you have to solo, clutch it. Never stay in one spot for too long because the enemy will flank the shit out of you. And like everything you kill is just gonna respawn behind you. And while you're not paying attention, GG, no re. You just gotta stick and move, stick and move, stick and move. Kill what you can. Kill what you can and move on. And when it comes to soloing, do not. 27 minutes? Goddamn! I didn't know it was gonna be that slow, Jesus. Never mind that, maybe I spoke too soon. who knows? Green check mop next to my name, that's all that matters. Kishik, platinum viable. Don't sleep on it. One shot, it doesn't one shot pyros unless you can get headshots. But everything else, energy drain or proxy bomb and shot to the chest work just fine. In the build, standard. I go for max damage on sniper rifle. Sniper rifle is all about that burst deeps, so. I take that risk. I prefer to get power duration to make sure I can get those hack objectives done. Those four hack objectives, but it's just a risky take when you go for deeps. Proximity mine only get 5. It's pretty much all you need. Debuffing power, and it still is relatively hard. 620, and that doesn't even factor in cloak bonuses. Energy drain, damage, restoration, armor boost. It's something to keep in mind. If you don't play as host often, do not take armor boost because it does not work off of host. Only works if you host. Just another Mass Effect 3 bug for you. What I do, what can I say? Weapon damage, power damage, weapon damage. Don't really know. I don't know, maybe if you take this, you'll start one-shotting pyros. I don't know. Something if no. I would honestly say I might even consider respecing energy drain to do full damage because if you hit energy drain against a target in cover, it will not knock them out of cover unless it completely strips their shields. And this build, it will work for gold, but for platinum, I don't really I'm not sure if it does. I don't know. I wasn't really paying too much attention during that game. Very chaotic. Fitness, 3 pity points, just make him a little more tanky. You can go no points in fitness, but I feel safer with the 3, and it, I don't know, an extra, what is that, 100 and, what, no? Extra 200 damage on a proximity bomb. Really not going to make or break this build. I don't know, your mileage may vary. If you feel the need for it, go for it. If you don't need the extra health and shields, whatever. I prefer health. So, yeah. It's a lot more chaotic than I would have liked train wreck of a commentary, that's for sure. But, the point stands. Kishik Harpoon Gun. Platinum viable. Don't sleep on it. One shots damn near everything, except pyros and bosses. But pyros are slow as shit anyway, easy to hit. hitting him with a 1-2 harpoon combo, not too hard. So
there you go. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And as always, peace soup.